matter how well-tuned an irrigation system may be, not all of the water makes it to the roots. Along the way, water evaporates in the air, or off leaves, or is blown around by wind and spreads unevenly on the ground. Here we'll walk through what's important to know about your irrigation's application efficiency and how it's not the same as wasted water. Everyone understands that sprinklers lose some water to evaporation, but there are more subtle inefficiencies too. Even with good spacing and no wind, sprinkler systems don't put out an even sheet of water. Unevenness means some areas are wetter than others, so some water is lost to leaching as we make sure drier areas get enough to drink. To reduce your inefficiencies, choose good sprinklers or nozzles that distribute water as evenly as possible, and make sure there's plenty of overlap from one sprinkler to the next. If you're somewhere windy, tighten up that spacing even more. Drip systems have similar problems. Even seemingly identical drip emitters differ slightly one from the other, making some areas wetter than others. You could buy better emitters with better specs, and you can use more emitters per tree to average out discrepancies. Drip systems must also use extra water to intentionally leach the root zone to make sure salts don't build up. All these inefficiencies are difficult to avoid. We expect them and we account for them. Wasted water is another story altogether. Waste includes leaks in pipes and fittings, or overwatering that leaches the soil, or water being applied so fast that it runs off the surface. Water is also wasted by uneven watering patterns from clogged emitters in poorly filtered drip lines, or unevenness from sprinklers with old nozzles, or pressures that are too high or too low. These problems are easily avoided, and they don't just waste water. The patchy growth and lost fertility reduces yields. To identify these kinds of waste, it's very helpful to install a flow meter at the source of your system. Measure flows for each zone or line when the system is new and running properly. Changes over time will alert you to problems. Leaks and worn parts will increase flows, while clogs reduce flows. Pressure gauges are a really inexpensive way to get great information about the health of your system. Pressure has a huge impact on every type of irrigation, changing flow rates, droplet sizes, and how evenly the water is spread out. If you fit a pitot tube on the end of a gauge, you can stick it right into the nozzle of a sprinkler or gun. You can use the same setup to tap into drip lines. Unless your emitters compensate for different pressures, even small variations can leave some crops thirsty while others drown. If you don't know how evenly your system applies water, you can measure it with just a stopwatch and a grid of 16 cans to catch water. The BC Irrigation Management Guide gives all the details for sprinklers, guns, center pivots, and drip. The test is simple. Irrigate for a while, then measure the water in each can. Take the average of all 16 cups and compare it to the average of the 4 cups with the least water in them. If the difference is more than 10 or 20%, you may be wasting water, and your system might just need a tune-up. But let's say your system is well-tuned. How efficient is it? Here are some rules of thumb. Sprinklers are about 70% efficient. That means if you put 10 gallons of water through your sprinkler system, only 7 gallons get into the soil around the roots of your crop. Put another way, if you sprinkle 3 inches of water on your crop, only a bit more than 2 inches will make it to the roots. Subsurface drip irrigation can't be beat at more than 95% efficient. Regular drip is about 90%, and low-pressure microsprinklers and center pivot rotators are about 80% efficient. Guns on reels are only about 65% efficient, while stationary guns are less than 60. Guns apply water so quickly that pooling and runoff are common problems, and the long throws are strongly affected by wind, so guns distribute water quite unevenly. This all brings us back to the question, how much should I irrigate? If you know how much water you need to get into the soil, it's simple. Just divide that amount by your irrigation efficiency. Let's say you want to get 2 inches of water into your soil. If you're using a traveling gun, you'll need to apply 3 inches of water. That's 2 inches divided by 65%. If you're using a pivot, you'll only need to apply 2.5 inches. That's 2 inches divided by 80%. And if you're using well-mulched drip irrigation, then you only need to apply 2.1 inches. That's 2 inches divided by 95%. If you've followed along with our video series, you'll realize we've done it. We have everything we need to answer the questions, how much and how often should I irrigate based on the weather? Let's review the whole process from the top. First, we figured out how much water our soils store, so we know how much water is available to our crops. Then we added up the amount of water our crops used since the last time we irrigated, and subtracted a bit of rainfall if we were lucky. And now we've added some extra water to make up for inefficiencies. And that's how much we irrigate. If that seems like a lot of math to do every week for every crop, don't worry. IIABC's handy online scheduling calculator can do all this hard work for you, and you'll be all set to water the right amount at the right time.